Hey guys, welcome back to TechoGround. Today we're gonna learn what is a drive list box, directory box, and file list box in Microsoft Visual Basic. So let's get started. As you can see, I have nothing written in my coding nor in my design. So you can see on the left side these three boxes. This is a drive list box, this is a directory list box, and this third one is a file list box. So the drive list box shows that all the drives in our computer, which are C, D, E and all that. And the directory list box show the number of folder in each of the drive. And then the file list box shows the files in all the folder. So now we will label this so that we can understand it properly. This is a drive list box. So change the caption, write drives, and then take another label, put it here and write it's a directory list box. And the third one is a file list box. So you will take the label 3 captions and write file. You can see when I run the program, when I change this drive list box, there is no change in these two, directory and file. So what we will do, we have to write a simple amount of coding here. So click on the drive list box and write, you can see the name of this is dir1, which is directory. So when the drive change, the dir1.path should be same as the drive1.drive. And now when we run the program, you can see when I change the drives, the folders are also changing. Now when I click on any of this folder, there is no change in the file list box. So to change the file list box, we will first close the book, click on the directory list box. And when the directory one changes, there should be change in the file one dot path, and it should be same as directory one dot path. Now we will run the program again. You can see now when I click on any folder, for example, I will select the D drive here, then go to any, for example, this YouTube folder. You can see it is showing all the files in our YouTube folder. Now when I click on the up, it is showing all the files in our up folder. Now you can go to any of the drive. And now what we will do, for example, if you want to see any particular type of file, we will create a pop-up menu. So how to create a pop-up menu? First, go to your form, click on the tools, click on the menu editor, and we have to create a menu. So first we will create, the name of the menu will be menu, and we'll write the caption same. Now click on the next and the right button. Now first you can see there are many type of files, so we will write the text file. We will write a program to search for the text file. Write the caption as text, and you can use the name same as caption. Click on next again, and then we will search for example, mp3 files. So you can write mp3 and then mp3, or we can search for some jpeg files. So we will write jpeg. So writing name will not make any changes. I am just writing so that you can understand. And then what you have to do, click on the menu and set the visible property to false, then press OK. Now you can see if I keep this visible and press OK, the menu can be seen here, but we want a pop-up menu, not a toolbox type menu. So we'll change the property to not visible. So click OK. Now you can see there is no. And now go to your coding and click on the form, and on the form choose mouse down. So when the mouse down button is pressed, the pop-up menu should appear. So the coding for the pop-up menu to appear is that we want to change the file list box. So what you have to do, go to the coding, write. We want our pop-up menu to appear anywhere on the form. So we will write first the name of the form. So form1, because the name of the form here is form1 dot. Now you have to use the pop-up menu method. And the name of the menu you have seen, we have written. Go to your design, go to tools and editor. You can see we have the name is the menu. So in the coding, you have to write form1 dot pop-up menu and the name of the menu, which is menu here, and then click. Then we will run the program and see. If I click the left or right mouse button, you can see there is an pop-up menu popping. It can be seen everywhere. So now if I click, there will be no changes. So what we have to do, we will write the coding on them. So now we will write coding on them. So what you have to do, go to your coding and then choose. You can see all the what we have written, the menu, mp3 and text are available here. So click, for example, if you want to see only the text file, and the text file will be seen in our, you can see the name of the file list box is file. So all the files will be seen here. So we will change the pattern of file list form. So to change the pattern, we have to write. So on the click of the text, you can see on the click of the text, what should happen? The file1.pattern equals to, you have to write this in double quote and write the extension. So .txt is the extension of a text file and write a star before that. So any file which has extension of .txt will be shown. Now we will choose our second, which is mp3. Do the same thing here. You can copy this code, this is just a one line code, and change this here mp3. Then select jpeg, again paste the lines and change this as jpeg. You can use any number of pop-up menu items. I'm using 3 only. So now we will run our program. You can see when we change our drives, the directories are also changing, and when we change our directory folder, the files are also changing. So what we will do, we will go to D and then we will go to the YouTube folder, and you can see there are text files. So if I select mp3, all the text files will be gone because there is no mp3. If I select the up folder, you can see there are mp3s. If I select on text, there are no text file here, so there are no text files shown. If you click on mp3, the mp3 file will be shown. JPG, there is no JPG file. We will again go to the folder. You can see there are no file, but there are text files in. Click on text. Now you can see all the text files are showing. So this is how you can use the drive list box, directory list box, and file list box with pop-up menu and search for the files you want. If you like the video, please press the like button. If you have any question, query, submission, or suggestion, please leave that in the comment box. Subscribe for more. Bye.